the South Campus of Macomb Community College for today's Eastern Conference doubleheader, featuring the visiting Henry Ford Hawks and your Macomb Monarchs. Now let's meet today's starting lineups. First for the Hawks in game one, leading off the right fielder, number 3, Ellen Nope. Batting second, catching number 12, Kylie Douglas. Batting third at shortstop is 13, Bella Lakitsky. Up fourth and at second base is 34, Jada Oliver. Batting fifth, the center fielder, number 40, Miley Garcia. Batting sixth and playing first base, number 36, Cameron Krizemin. Batting seventh and at third base is 15, Jalen Reyes. Batting eighth, the pitcher, 44, Caitlin Postuma. And batting ninth, the left fielder, number 21, Ashley Goodman. The Hawks are coached by Steve Littleton. And now, let's meet the Game 1 starters for your Macomb Monarchs. Leading off, the center fielder, number 8, Savannah Clark. Batting second, the shortstop, number 22, Allie Presnell. Batting third and playing third base, number 24, Bryn Fryer. Batting cleanup and at first base is number 14, Carly Pilpo. Batting fifth and playing second base, number 21, Katie Thomas. Batting sixth, the designated player, 00, Sydney Urban. Batting seventh and in right field is number 5, Haley Mitchell. Batting eighth, the left fielder, number 6, Zoe Hunt. And batting ninth and catching is number 35, Casey Stang. The game one pitcher for the Monarchs is number 3, Grace Jankowski. The Monarchs head coach in his 8th season is Jim Beard. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if you could please rise and gentlemen, remove your caps for the playing of our national anthem.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to the Macomb Monarchs Athletic Network for another installation of Monarch Softball. It's a huge MCCAA East doubleheader today as your Macomb Monarchs are taking on the Henry Ford College Hawks. My name is Tom Cavanaugh, taking you through both doubleheaders today, or both games for our doubleheader, 2 7-inning bouts between these two. Let's get into the tail of the tape between these two squads. It's been a rough go so far this year for Henry Ford. They're 2-15 overall, 2-10 in conference. And on the opposite side, Macomb, 12-9 on the season and 8-3 in that MCCAA East division. These are big games for Macomb today. They have split their past two doubleheaders last week. They're going to need to get on the right foot today if they're going to want to try to catch Mott Community College at the top of that East division. On the mound today, no stranger for these Monarchs, it's Grace Jankowski, the hard-throwing right-hander. She is coming off an incredible performance last week. She pitched a 6-inning no-hitter with 6 innings, 1 walk, and 4 strikeouts, taking down Schoolcraft. And then Grace pitched in game 2. She gave up 6 hits in just 2 innings, 5 runs allowed in those 2 innings. But Can't say enough about that no-hitter she put together in game one back on April 6th. And we're set to go here. Defensive lineups today for Macomb. Behind the dish, it's Casey Stang. At third base, Bryn Beyer. Your shortstop, Allie Prasnak. At second, Katie Thomas. We'll get into her MCCAA East Player of the Week award later today. Over at first, Carly Bilpo. In the outfield from left to right, you have Zoe Hunt, Savannah Clark, and Haley Mitchell. Ellen Oak has stepped in the left-handed box, and we're set to go. Home plate umpire Robert Hinojosa in the field. It's Al Diver. First pitch on the ground, a shortstop. Prasnak, nice play, guns to first. Bang, bang, play. They got her. Good start for Joukowsky.
Game time temperature, 63 degrees.
You heard from our PA man doing the stats today, Tim Johnston, the SID over here at Macomb. 3 o'clock start, 64 degrees here in Warren, Michigan. A beautiful Wednesday afternoon. One up, one down. Here's Kylie Douglas. Joukowsky's first delivery is high and outside for a ball. Douglas doing the catching today for the Hawks. Henry Ford has lost four of their last five, but got a huge conference win against Schoolcraft the other day, splitting against the Ocelots. Line drive right back towards us, makes it 1-1. They lost four in a row before taking down Schoolcraft 7-1. As we said, split that doubleheader there in the very bottom of that East Division. And these are huge games for Macomb on the opposite side, considering they're just a couple of games out of first place. They sit comfortably in second right now. Fastball a bit low. You got St. Clair County Community College actually right on the tails of Macomb. They have three more losses and one less win. So a couple W's today for the Monarchs would really set them apart into that top two. There's a ball high and inside, 3-1 now. She said Joukowsky, one walk, four strikeouts. That only walk in her no-hitter last week came in the first inning. She went shutout for the next five frames. Macomb on the opposite end. We talked about them splitting their past two doubleheaders, splitting against OCC and Schoolcraft. Here's a high pop-up into center field. Coming in is Clark. She's going to call off her second baseman, Thomas, and there's two gone in the top of the first inning.
The batter, 13, Bella Lukitsky.
Last time Macomb was able to sweep a doubleheader was back earlier this season, March 22nd against OCC. Check that, the 26th against OCC. They've split every one since then. It bounces away. That's where those three losses come from in the conference. They got a huge win against Mott, though, here at home. Had to come from behind. Sydney Urban was your hero with a grand slam in the bottom of the sixth. Bella Lukitsky takes the first pitch outside. It's 1-0. Heavy right-handed lineup here for Henry Ford today. That pitch misses down and inside. Lutzkitsky's up. It'll be Jada Oliver next. Millie Garcia, Cameron Krizemin, Jalen Reyes, Caitlin Postuma, and Ashley Goodman. Joukowsky leans in, now rocks back, fires, and here's a line drive in the left center field gap for Bella Lukitsky. She's going to hold up at first base with a two-out single. Put a nice swing on that.
The batter, 34, Jada Oliver.
And seeing this Henry Ford team, they lost both to Mott over in Flint earlier this year, but they played them tough in both games. It was a low-scoring contest in game one. Game two was a lot like that in the opening few innings, but then the Bears ended up pulling away in that one. But there's some hitters on this Hawks team. Even with a 2-15 record, both of those wins in conference, they could pop off and win a game at any time, considering taking down Schoolcraft 7-1. Here's Jada Oliver. She's at second base today. A little bit of an overcast with a little bit of wind blowing out towards right field at the moment. Ground ball. It's to shortstop. Prasnak makes a forehand play and just has to touch onto the bag at second for out number three. Good inning for Joukowsky and your Monarchs. We head to the bottom of the first. No score between Henry Ford College and Macomb from a doubleheader here in Warren. We'll be right back as Macomb comes to hit. This is your home for Macomb Community College Athletics. the Monarchs come to the plate, let's check out the Henry Ford defensive lineup and who they have on the mound here for game one. It's Caitlin Postuma, the freshman, making her 12th appearance of the year. She has walked 12 and struck out 26 in 32 and two-thirds innings. So she's going to fill up the zone and get a swing and a miss here and there. She has also given up 40 runs on 45 hits in those 32 and two-thirds innings. Kylie Douglas behind the plate. Jalen Reyes is at third. Lakitsky at short. Jada Oliver at second base. Caitlin Krizemin playing first. Goodman's in left. Millie Garcia's in center. And Ellen Oak out in right. Savannah Clark, your everyday leadoff hitter in that left-handed box. Going to start things off for the Monarchs in the home half of the first. Squaring the bunt, she'll pull back. Regardless, it's a strike on the outside corner. Clark, Prasnak, Beyer, usual suspects here for the Monarchs in the bottom half. Here's another bunt attempt, this time foul towards head coach Jim Beard in his eighth season down that third baseline. Ball bounces low and inside. Monarchs hitting 360 as a team to combine. Also scored 151 runs in 21 games this year. Off the plate outside. Clark all the way up in that box as she moves through. Infield fairly in right now, expecting that bunt attempt. Not with two strikes as this change piece misses down and away. We're going to go to a full count to the leadoff batter, Savannah Clark. Full doubleheader on tap today from Warren, Michigan on the campus of Macomb Community College. Henry Ford and your Monarchs. There's a little shot the other way. Nice play at third from Reyes, and she throws out Clark. And there's one out.
The batter, number 22, Ellie Prasnak.
I'll bring up Ellie Prasnak. Smoking hot, 448 average on the year. 21 runs scored, 30 hits, and 67 ABs. There's a line back to the screen. Saw her make a nice play at shortstop, as she has been all year long. Doesn't leave from that spot at short. She did come on the pitch last week. It was a first time throwing all year long. Another foul ball just underneath it. She's timing it up nicely, 0-2. Prasnak. A ton of extra base hits. She's got 10 doubles, 4 triples, and 5 home runs for a total of 24 RBIs. High pop-up foul out of play. Good fight from Allie at the dish. Review those dimensions one more time. About 45 feet, maybe 50 from chalk all the way to the fence and foul ground. Then you have 200 feet all the way around on the fence. Especially the dead center, if you get a hold of one, it's out of here. Postuma leaves one up and out. It's now 1-2. Good take from Allie. It's now leveled at 2-2 with one out. No score in the bottom of the first inning. Macomb and Henry Ford. Diving into the middle of April. This is the only full month of the season for, I guess, competition. Only a few games in early May, and then you head on to conference playoffs and such. Three balls, two strikes to Prasnak. Trying to draw Walker, have a hit here, and she takes a ball outside. Nice fight from Allie Prasnak. She was down 0-2 on the first three pitches of the at-bat. She comes all the way back.
Number 24, Bryn Beyer.
One on, one out for Bryn Beyer. Beyer hit 370 this year, 20 hits, 3 doubles, 2 homers, and 16 RBIs for Bryn. Takes one outside for a ball. Puts the ball in play most times, 3 walks and 2 strikeouts for Prasnak. Going to try and steal second base. She slides in safely. Stolen bag for Prasnak, and now a runner in scoring position in the opening inning for Macomb. Reyes at third base. She's two or three steps in front of the bag as this ball bounces up in the dirt. Good block behind the dish from Kylie Douglas. 3-0 to Bryn Beyer. Right down the heart of the plate for a strike. Nice pitch from Caitlin Postuma. Henry Ford with a 1-5 road record. The same record over at home. For only two wins of the year, as we said, against Schoolcraft and then against OCC back on Friday, the 29th of March. That was the best their offense played all year as well. 11-1 victory against OCC. Pulled on the ground. Backhand play from Reyes. Throws on to first and down to third base will go Prasnak on the toss. Beyer grounds out but moves the runner up to third, 60 feet away.
Batting, number 14, Carly Bilbo.
They'll bring up Carly Bilbo, the first baseman. Second lefty in this lineup. Henry Ford trying to get out of the first unscathed. Allie Prasnak worked an 8-pitch walk. And now it's Bilbo with two gone. Pitch is off the plate outside. Douglas couldn't quite keep it right there on the corner. 64 degrees and just cloudy here. It's honestly a perfect day for softball. Here's an off speed inside and high. Three balls and no strikes to Bilbo. Or check that, 2-1. Spoke too soon. It was a little bit of a late call from our guy Robert Hinojosa behind the dish. Swing and a miss, makes it 2-2. Oliver at second base, shaded a little bit towards first. The 2-2 pitch is in the air. Out of play, foul. Not a lot of backstop space over here, but if that ball is able to kick away from the catcher, Douglas, there's a chance that Prasnak can sneak in and score. 2-2, ground ball to second. Clean play from Oliver. Quick toss on to first. Monarch Strand, a runner at third base. Not able to score, we go to the second. 0-0 between the Hawks and the Monarchs here from the Macomb Athletic Network.
The batter 40, Miley Garcia.
Top of the second inning. 14 to play if we do get all seven innings in both games. It's the 5-6-7 hitters with Millie Garcia starting things off, and she's gonna take a ball down and away, and Casey Stang sends one out to Savannah Clarkson Center to make sure she's still out there, staying lively. Always want to keep your entire outfield engaged, even on just a regular strike pitch on the inside half there. Garcia's in center field for the Hawks today. She's going to sky one in the air. Foul ground, right side. little bit of a chase, and no one's able to grab it. Thomas and Bilpo were the closest to it. Henry Ford, coached by Steve Littleton. He's in his first year. He also brought aboard his daughter, Kelsey Littleton, who played at Madonna. She's coaching first. Stevens down at third, and here's a ball in the dirt. 2-1. Garcia at the plate, hitting 228 this season. She's going to leave one inside. That just misses. She's walked three times, struck out nine. Not a ton of extra base power, just two doubles so far this year for her. Three balls, one strike. Joukowsky wants to get up to the right foot here in the second inning. Low and inside for a ball. Leadoff walk to Millie Garcia. Has one aboard.
The batter 36, Cameron Krizemin.
Bring up the first baseman, Cameron Krizemin. Freshman pitcher slash first baseman. Eight total hits this year with nine RBIs. That ball's low in the dirt. Steal attempt, the throw down, and she is safe, but was collided with by the glove. More times than not, we're seeing that happen on steal attempts, just the tag hitting her in the face. Up on her feet, Garcia is safe, and she's okay. Happened back against the Bears here in a doubleheader. It was a steal attempt from Mott, and Prasnak's tag was right in the teeth of one of the Bears' runners. And the same thing happened right now. Garcia was in mid-slide, but she wasn't down far enough, so when that tag hit her, she hit the deck. Runner on second, nobody out here for the Hawks. Cam Krizemin holding a 1-0 count. Got Beyer over at third base. She's hugging the line, very close. This ball's in the dirt. It's going to get by Stang. Home plate umpire Robert Hinojosa has his hands up. Are they going to call that a hit by pitch? They do, even though it bounced. So a bouncing pitch that hits Cam Krizemin is going to put two aboard. That's interesting. Jalen Reyes steps to the plate, and a great chance. Henry Ford with something cooking right now. A walk and a hit batter. Very rare mistakes here from Joukowsky on the mound. You never really see that. Got great command, is able to battle back with strikes when she falls down and counts and dominating hitters. Got to work out of a two-runner jam with nobody out here. Bottom of the lineup coming up. Reyes going to square around to Bunt. She pops it up. Stang comes over and makes the catch in foul ground. Jalen Reyes blunders the bunt attempt on the first chance, and there's one gone with runners on first and second.
The batter 44, Caitlin Posterman.
You just cannot allow that to happen. And that's the difference between the teams that are at the top of the East Division in the MCCAA and the ones at the bottom. You have to be able to get those sack bunt attempts down and move runners up into scoring position. Fastball high and inside as a ball. 1-0 to Posthuma. She's also our pitcher today for the Hawks. Prasnak playing very off the bag at shortstop. She's playing in that hole for pull. Thomas on the opposite end. She's looking for a little slap the other way. High sky fly ball. Not deep. Prasnak goes back and makes the catch right on the outfield grass cutout. Great bounce back from Grace Joukowsky on the mound. A walk and a hit batter, and she induces two pop-ups. One to Stang behind the dish, and one right behind second base. Prasnak made the catch. Last batter in this Hawks lineup, Ashley Goodman, playing left field. Holds that bat still over the left ear. First pitch is in the dirt. Nice stop from Casey. Already seen one get by her. It wasn't actually her fault at all. There was no chance of her being able to block that ball up as it hit a piece of Cam Krizemin and then kicked off towards the dugout. No score. We're in the top of the second inning. McComb and Henry Ford. Fastball off the plate, 2-0.
The
Monarchs looking to get out of a jam. They had a runner at second, but third base last inning were unable to convert. They got to return the favor. Big cut and a miss. Way out in front of that one was Goodman. Jakowski, 47 strikeouts, 41 walks this year. Line back to the screen, makes it 2-2 with two outs. Big swing coming from Ashley Goodman if she wants to put her team ahead early in this one. These are pivotal games for the Monarchs. Trying to further themselves into second place and steal a couple games as they face Mott later this week. What a pitch from Grace Jakowski. Freezes Ashley Goodman for her first strikeout of the day. We head to the bottom of the second inning. No score as the Hawks strand two with nobody out. You're watching the Macomb Community College Athletic Network. We'll be right back.
Leading off the second for the Monarchs, number 21, Katie Thomas.
Bottom of the second inning, another chance here for the Monarchs. Left one at second base last inning in Allie Prajnak, or at third rather. And it's going to be the 5-6-7 batter starting with Katie Thomas. Your MCCAA East Player of the Week. She's going to leave that ball in the dirt, 2-0. Thomas hit a blistering 786 average with six doubles. She was 11 for 14 at the plate last week. That's incredible. Rightfully deserves that award as this is a high pop-up. Jada Oliver is able to make the catch as she crosses into foul ground. Thomas with a pop-out, one away.
The batter. Double zero, Sydney Irvin.
Sydney Irvin now steps in. 344 average for Sydney. Lead the team with six home runs, and she swings and misses at a high fastball. 0-1. Also leads the team in RBIs with 27. Prajnak right behind her in both categories with five homers. And here's another one for Urban. Takes the 1-1 out to right field. Big swing from Sydney, and it's 1-0 Macomb early on. Said Prajnak was keeping close with those home runs, and Urban makes it 7 now for her, widening that lead. And they're up 1-0. Something we've really gotten used to this year is Sydney Irvin just unloading on softballs out to right field.
Number five, Haley.
She's put a few out to center as well, but her happy spot is out there in deep right field beyond that fence about 45 to 50 feet. Here's Haley Mitchell, excuse me. She fouls it right back, 0-1. One out and a run scored. Irvin, and yet another home run, picking up her 28th RBI of the year. Mitchell turns that right foot in a little bit as she takes a high changeup, 1-1. Mitchell, Zoe Hunt, and Casey Stang to finish out this Monarch lineup. Another pitch misses up and in. That was Sydney Urban's 23rd hit of the year and her seventh home run. Almost a third of her swings are homers. It's unbelievable. The 2-2, line drive, fair ball down the left field line. A little bit of spin, kicks it into foul territory. It's gonna be just a single for Haley Mitchell. Nice opposite field swing there with one out. Took with the pitcher, Postuma gave her there, outside fastball, and she just put the barrel to it. Looks like we're gonna get a runner here for the right fielder, Haley Mitchell. Might be Canton or Oleski, whoever comes out of that left-sided dugout. It's gonna be Spencer Oleski, number seven.
Here then, please, now running at first base for the Monarchs, at number seven, Spencer Oleski.
So as Oleski changes on to first base, it's Zoe Hunt's turn. High and outside for the opening pitch, 1-0. Last time we were covering the Monarchs here at home, they were taking on Schoolcraft. Zoe Hunt ended the ball game in an 8-0 victory. She had a two-run shot in the bottom of the sixth to seal it. Another pitch misses up and away, 2-0. It was Hunt's first homer of the year, but really promising to see her have that type of power. She had a nice swing the at-bat before, but it was caught in center field because she hit it too hard. It was a line drive out to center. 2-0, squaring the bunt, throw down to second base. Oleski, she's gonna be thrown out. Kindly Douglas gets the runner down at second base for out number two. So Mitchell's single is foiled. Oleski tried to swipe the bag as Hunt went to bunt it. And Zoe Hunt might need to hold that bat out a little bit longer to obstruct the vision of Kylie Douglas behind the plate. One of your, I guess, jobs as a hitter whenever you have a runner going and you know you're not gonna offer at the pitch, make it tough for the catcher. Hold that bat out there as long as possible so she's not able to have a clean throw down to second base to get the runner. Three balls and one strike to Hunt. She pops one up out of play, 3-2 now. One run in the inning, thanks to Sydney Urban, her seventh home run of the year. Went deep out to right field, a no-doubter, as most of them are. Postum on the mound. Leans back, fires, and the 3-2 is high for ball four.
Now batting for
two out walk brings up Casey Stang. Stang just three doubles on this season, eight RBIs as well. Incredible defensively behind the plate. Has the arm to match the footwork, blocking up the balls. It's 1-0. Hunt at first base, she just worked a full count walk, and Stang's gonna pop one up foul. That wind's starting to die down a little bit, still headed out towards right field, favoring that Urban home run earlier. But not as strong as it was last week. Hopefully getting into those better weather days. You never know here in Michigan. Might get another 30 degree day later this week. And we're expected to get some rain. Hopefully the baseball softball gods hold that off. We're able to continue to play the next couple of days. Here's the 2-1 to Stang, up and out. Good hitters count for Casey. Three balls, one strike. It's 1-0 Macomb here in inning number two of the first game of our doubleheader. Fighting on that one. Stang puts that out of play. Another full count. Second straight here for Postuma on the mound. Already talked about her numbers. 26 strikeouts, 22 walks, and she's gonna walk another one right here. That's two in a row, making that 23 and 24 on the year. Both 3-2 counts, and you can't fault Postuma more than you can award both the hitters, Hunt and Stang, being able to foul off pitches and work that all the way into a full count. Two aboard with two out, back to Savannah Clark. Looking a squared up bunt. Gonna pull back there, and you saw the third baseman, Jalen Reyes, coming in hard. Maybe Hunt's able to take third base. Good defensive rotation with Bella Lakitsky covering the bag. One ball, no strikes to Savannah Clark, and she's gonna bunt it right back to the mound. Postuma throws to first, and she's out. Clark, in a bang-bang play, is called out, but the Monarchs grab a run on the Sidney Urban solo shot. We go to the top of the third inning, 1-0. Macomb on top of Henry Ford. This is your home for Macomb softball.
Leading off for the Hawks, number 3, Ellen Oak.
Back to the top of the lineup for Henry Ford. Ellen Oak grounded out to shortstop on the first pitch to open up the game. She's going to face Drace Jakowski for the second time. Jakowski threw two innings. She's given up one hit, walked two, and has struck out one. Leaves the first pitch outside to Ella. It's 1-0 Macomb. Sidney Urban went deep last half inning. Slap swing, foul towards the left side. Evens the count up, 1-1. Some other news inside of Macomb Community College Athletics. Juwan Maxey, the Macomb basketball team, was awarded second team All-American. He's a third in three seasons to do it, fourth in history. There's an off-speed pitch on the outside corner, freezing Noak. She's down 1-2, but Maxey, he's one of three. John Ukamadu from Eastern Kentucky, Aiden Rubio, who played at Central Michigan, and now Juwan Maxey. He gets that award yesterday. The 1-2 is high out of the glove of Stang. Two balls and two strikes to the leadoff hitter to open up the third inning. We saw Maxey just shine in the District Great Lakes tournament that happened over at Mott Community College a few weeks ago. And he joins a very elite group of guys. Wow, what a pitch from Grace Jakowski. Another off-speed that just gets no chopping wood at that one. Second straight strikeout. She wanted to commit at it, then got frozen, and then tried to swing at the last second. Kylie Douglas, a flyout victim her first time. Want to know on that fastball outside. Jakowski's not been able to get ahead of hitters too well today, but has battled back. We said just the two strikeouts in her last two batters, but a lot of flyouts. She got Douglas, Postuma, Reyes, and just two ground balls as well. Here's a fly ball to left center field. Does not have the distance. Zoe Hunt calling for it in the left center gap and puts that away for out number two. There's another fly ball right there from Jakowski. She gets down 1-0 and then delivers a pretty solid pitch in the middle to hit in Kylie Douglas, who we've seen already have three doubles in a game earlier this year against Mott. Bella Lakitsky with the solo swing right now. She's got the only hit. She lines the first one back. Bella lined one in the left center field her last time on a 1-1. Jakowski holds it at the belt, now delivers another off-speed pitch. That's a strike. Quickly 0-2 to Bella Lakitsky. And this off-speed is really working for Grace on the mound. I mean, continuing to just get these Hawk hitters off balance. Foul back. Again, 0-2. O-2 with two outs. Ground ball up the middle. It's going to be a play on for Thomas. Throw to first is in time. 1-2-3 frame for Jakowski and the Monarchs. We go to the bottom of the third. 1-0. Macomb on top.
Leading off for the Monarchs, number 22, Allie Presnack.
Monarchs go back to work here. Bottom of the third inning against Caitlin Postuma. It's going to be the second at-bat here for Allie Presnack. Waiting for our first base coach. And we're all good. Postuma leaves the first pitch down. Presnack worked a nice walk last time. She trailed in the count 0-2 and came all the way back. Fouled a couple pitches off. She was stranded at third base back in the first inning. 1-0. Sydney Urban with the solo shot is the difference so far today. 1-1. Presnack not missing it by much. When you see those balls shoot right back towards us on the screen, you know the timing's right. It's just the level of the swing. A little bit underneath it or on top, depending. 1-1 to Allie. She pops it up in the air to center field. Scaling back is Garcia, and she's going to make the catch a few feet away from the warning track in right center. There's a good swing from Allie, just a little bit too underneath that one. Popped it straight up.
The batter, number 24, Bryn Boyer.
So a quick first down for Postuma and the Hawks. They're looking to survive it in the late couple of innings where anything can happen in a close game. Macomb would really like to score a crooked number in these next few frames with Bryn Boyer at the plate. Bryn pulls one fouled on the third baseline. She was a little bit out ahead of that one as she shakes her hands. Got it off the very tip of the bat. I know it's not that cold right now, but it still is never fun when you catch it on the handle or the end of the bat. Boyer puts it on the ground. Foul. Jalen Reyes has been playing just two steps away from that third baseline all day long. I don't know if anything's going to be able to sneak down that third baseline unless it's just screamed. That pitch misses out. Good take. One ball and two strikes now to Beyer. Pastrma delivers and evens the count as she misses with that fastball. Outfield fairly deep right now for Henry Ford. Ellen Noak, the most shallow in right field, as this one's put out there on one hop. Bryn Beyer, she's got herself a hit. Single for Beyer, puts one on with one out.
14, Carly.
One thing that really impresses me by watching this Macomb team is the ability to go opposite field with a lot of their hitting. And they're not doing too much with it. You see the bombs, the doubles in the gap, the triples that comes from this team, but they don't force it. If they're able to just poke the ball the other way and use some good hitting techniques, then they're going to get it done, which they have day in, day out. Ball in the dirt. Beyer is able to take second base without a throw. That ball kind of hung around the feet of Kylie Douglas. She was unable to find it for a moment, and that gave Beyer time. One ball, no strikes to Bilpo, wagging that bat. She pulls it on the ground to shortstop. Oliver sneaks underneath her glove. Down to third, and now trying to score is going to be Beyer. The throw is not in time. Heads up, base running and coaching. Gets the second run in. Beyer comes all the way around to score on the error. Bilpo hangs out at first. And how about head coach Jim Beard seeing that ball trickle past the second baseman, Jada Oliver's glove, and Beard center all the way around third base. Well done. Chloe Canton's going to grab a helmet and some batting gloves, and she'll take first base in place of Bilpo.
Your attention, please. Now running at first base for the Monarchs is number two, Chloe Canton.
Canton's 2-for-2, stealing bases on the year. We've already seen the arm of Kylie Douglas behind the plate. She's already thrown out one runner today. It's Katie Thomas's turn, and she cuts and misses at the first pitch, high and outside. 2-0 Macomb after the Jada Oliver error that led to a run. Beyer scored all the way around from second base. 0-1 is in the dirt. Good stop from Douglas as she takes a look down at first base at the runner, Canton. Olesky, the other pinch runner, was thrown out last inning. Douglas might have to try her hand at it again. That pitch is dropped up near the shoulders. Thomas takes all the way, 2-1. It's a slow start offensively for Macomb right now, besides Sydney Urban having her home run, but they're going to start digging their heels in these later innings. 3-1 now. Thomas, one of the better eyes on this team, takes that one up and out. Bostroma's ready. The 3-1 pitch is high and away. Ball four. Runners on first and second now with one out. That's walk number three for Bostroma today. And the most dangerous hitter in this lineup, Sydney Urban, with two aboard. And this is not a second and third situation where you're able to just intentionally put the hitter on. You got a pitch to her here. Ball down and outside. 5 straight right now for Pastrma on the mound. All of those missing high and kind of out of the zone to the lefty here, which was inside to our last hitter. Pastrma wisely trying to keep it away to the outside of Urban, 2-0. Two on with one out. It's 2-0 Macomb. Urban, big swing and a miss. She was out in front of that one. That's the only way that Henry Ford's going to be able to avoid Sydney Urban right now is kind of mixing up those timings with off-speed pitches. Get her out on that front foot. 2-1 fastball is just missing to the left. It's now 3-1. Urban, close stance, holds that bat in tight near the left ear with a little bit of a wag. She lines one, caught at third base from Reyes. stealing a double from Sydney Urban right there. What a play. In a split second, Jalen Reyes puts her glove up and makes a line drive catch for out number two. What a swing from Urban right there. Instead of going deep to right field, she shot it the other way and just in the wrong spot. Haley Mitchell, base hit her first time up last inning. Chloe Canton down at second base, Katie Thomas at first. Strike called at the letters, 1-1. Macomb sporting their home gray jerseys with navy blue pinstriping. Block numbers and names on the back in navy blue with white cutout. Good off-speed pitch, just misses. Not by much, it's now 2-1 to Mitchell. Henry Ford in their black jerseys with blue and white block Henry Ford across the front, numbers on the back. Mitchell chops one, back to the mound. Postuma's got to make a quick play, throw on the first, and they got her. Mitchell's out, and so are the Monarchs. They get a run after the error as Bryn Beyer comes around. 2-0, Macomb. We go to the bottom of the third inning, or check that, top of the fourth inning. Monarchs on top. This is your home for Macomb Athletics.
Leading off for the Hawks, 34, Jada Oliver.
Grace Schakowsky back to work on the mound. She's going into her fourth inning right now, protecting a 2-0 lead against Henry Ford. Jada Oliver takes the first pitch out to left field, and Zoe Hunt takes two steps to her right. One up, one down. Another flyout for Jakowski right now. That's two out there to Hunt. And there's been one out to the center fielder, Clark, and then a couple on the infield. So doing a good job. Again, lazy contact in the air. Grace Jakowski getting it done after a first inning, or a second inning, really, when she put a couple of runners on early. Walked the leadoff batter, Garcia, who's at the dish now, and then hit Cam Krizemin. But worked out of a jam after that. Back-to-back pop-outs and a strikeout looking to end the frame. Beautiful off-speed pitch from Grace again. I mean, really, like, right there, Millie Garcia, who's down 0-2. All of her weight's on that front foot, and there's nowhere else to go with the bat than completely out in front, missing the ball. Stang tries to hold that one in there on the corner, just missing 1-2. Talked about the totals for strikeouts and walks. They are both high, 47 strikeouts, 41 walks, but that means that she's effective even when she is not controlling her command. There's a tap foul. So there's times when Jakowski can get a little wild, walk a couple, but she's gonna come right back with some strikes. And we saw that in the second inning. We just talked about it. Here's the 1-2 pitch. Way high and outside. Stang's got to hop up out of her stance, can't make the catch. Little extra velo on that last. We're in game one of two here from Warren, Michigan on the campus of Macomb Community College. Here's a high pop up. Not out of play, but not catchable for any of the Monarch defenders. Monarchs gonna go on the road Friday That's at Kersley Park in Flint, Michigan, taking on the Mott Bears. And then that next day, it's going to be four games in 2 days for Macomb. They're going to play this Henry Ford team on the road in Taylor on the 13th, as we said, Saturday. 3 balls and 2 strikes. Timmy Garcia with one out, nobody on. Stang setting up on the outer half. 3-2 pitch. Inside corner, strike three. So Stang was kind of sitting on the outer half. Jakowski went on the inside, but still gets it for a strike. Garcia goes down looking. That'll bring up Cameron Krizemin. She was hit by a pitch as it bounced in. Love to see the NJCAA rule book for bouncing balls that are considered hit by pitches. There's a strike on the inside corner. Top of the fourth inning. 2-0 lead for the Macomb Monarchs. Urban has a home run, and Beyer came around to score on some heady base running. Krizemin's almost hitting the foot again. This one is inside, 1 ball and 1 strike. Jakowski's 1-1 offering. Same spot as the first strike, it's now 1-2. Wind still lightly blowing out to right field at the moment. Haley Mitchell playing deep out there in right, and there's a swing and a miss. Back-to-back strikeouts, that's 4 total for Grace Jakowski. Monarchs lead 2-0 as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning. This is your home for Macomb Community College Athletics. You're watching the Macomb Athletic Network.
Leading off for the Monarchs, number 6, Zoe Hunt.
Monarchs have scored a run in each of the last 2 innings. They're looking for more here in the fourth. Tom Cavanaugh taking you all the way through our doubleheader today as the Monarchs take on Henry Ford College. Hunt lines the first pitch back to the screen. Zoe Hunt playing left field in the 8th spot today, walked, stranded at second base her first time. Hunt hitting .389 on the year. 14 total hits. She's got 9 RBIs. She'll take a fastball outside, 1-1. Caitlin Postuma's back on the mound for Henry Ford as well. Corner infielder's in for the Hawks. Middle infielder's even with the bag. Good take from Zoe, makes it 2 balls and 1 strike. So Macomb, as we said, taking on Mott later this week, and Macomb could pick up a couple games here. They're 8-3 in conference. There's a strike on the outside corner, and that Mott team 11-1 in conference. So if Macomb's able to get a couple games here, they'll be 10-3 facing the 11-1 Bears on Friday. And however that doubleheader turns out, could be pivotal for first place. Here's the ball on the ground from Zoe Hunt. Nice play from Lakitsky, and there's one gone.
Now batting for the Monarchs, number 35, Casey Stang.
Brings up Casey Stang with one out. Hunt talking with Stang, making some adjustments there with how Postuma is delivering this. Ball low in the dirt. Stang is taking all the way. She also walked last time. That's back in the second inning after the Urban homer. Postuma, very high in pitch count right now. She's at 79. She leaves another one low. Three hits, two runs, four walks, and no strikeouts for Caitlin on the mound right now. Stang trying to turn the lineup back over with one out. Here's the ball low. Stang on the 3-0, puts one on the ground to shortstop. Lukitsky, clean play. And Stang takes a hack at the 3-0 pitch, hits it hard. But Bella Lukitsky makes back-to-back plays, and there's two gone.
The batter, number eight, Savannah Clark.
Two groundouts today for Savannah. She comes to the dish. 2-0 Macomb. It's a low-scoring affair right now. Henry Ford, we said, lost five of the last six, had a big win against Schoolcraft, grabbing that 7-1. It's one game or the other for them. They're either going to give up low runs, or they're going to give up a ton and compete in both games. Here's a pop-up to Lukitsky, and she makes all three plays in the fourth inning for the Hawks. Nice job from Bella and Henry Ford. They hold Macomb scoreless for the first time since the very first inning of the ball game. We go to the top of the fifth. 2-0 Monarchs on top of Henry Ford. This is your home for Macomb Community College Athletics.
Leading off for the Hawks, 15, Jalen Reyes.
Back to work. Go the Monarchs on defense. Same thing for the Hawks on offense with 7-8-9 hitters. Jalen Reyes, Caitlin Postuma, and Ashley Goodland coming to the dish. Jakowski has found her groove halfway through this one. She's got back-to-back strikeouts to end the fourth inning, four total. Approaching 50 pitches now, or she just hit 50 pitches. There's an off-speed on the inside corner. That's mixing up speeds and angles. She just went on the outside corner with a fastball and now drops an off-speed pitch on the inside half. 0-2 to Reyes. She popped out to the catcher on a bunt attempt last time. Fastball misses in the left-handed box. Bella Lukitsky, back in the first inning, had that solo hit. That's really been all today for Henry Ford. Out of play, keeping it at 1-2. They did have a few base runners in the second off of a walk and a hit batter. Reyes made a really nice play earlier today at third, and here's a fly ball to left center field. Hunt in a few steps, now scales back. And that's out number one. Nice play from Zoe Hunt, tracking it down in the gap.
Now batting for the Hawks, 44, Caitlin Postuma.
A very underrated aspect of playing the outfield is communication between your outfielders, especially with those high fly balls in the gap. Depending on whose momentum is coming towards the ball to help out a throw into the infield, that's going to also depend on who's going to catch that ball. Sun not really a factor much right now with a little bit of cloud coverage, so that's another thing you can take into account when communicating between outfielders. 1-0 to the pitcher, Postuma. Make that 2-0. Caitlin popped out to shortstop last time, just behind second base. That was back in the inning when Jakowski was able to get out of it with two on, nobody out. Those are big, big outs too, especially in a very low scoring game, just two so far. The one big swing, we talked about it several times, Sydney Urban went deep in the second. And the only other run was scored because of Bryn Beyer and head coach Jim Beard sending Beyer home on an error. Here's a fastball inside for ball four. Jakowski walks Postuma.
Drops 21. Ashley Goodman.
So Caitlin's able to help herself out and get on the base paths, and now Ashley Goodman. Likely going to be getting a pinch runner here. We will. It's number 19, Ayolani Fernandez. Sophomore out of the Bronx, New York.
Here, touch it, please. Now running at first for the Hawks, number 19, Ayolani Fernandez.
I'll keep Goodman at the dish. Appreciate third base full head coach Steve Littleton giving a stat update there. Strikeout looking for Goodman, her first time. She's got one on with one out. It's Ayolani Fernandez running at first base, and she's going to get down to second. Stang lets that ball fumble around and fall behind her. So a walk to Postuma puts a runner on. Fernandez, the pinch runner, down to second, and it's 1-0 right now to Goodman. Way in the other batter's box as well. Two balls, no strikes. Infield playing more in than usual up the middle with both Thomas and Prasnak, even with the baseline. Three balls and no strikes right now to the last batter in the lineup, Ashley Goodman. Goodman hitting 326 this year. She's got 14 total knocks, and this is her fourth walk of the season. Four straight to Goodman, back-to-back walks for Jakowski, and that's where you see kind of those numbers of strikeouts to walks really starting to even up. She's able to strike out four or five in the first couple of innings, but now she's got three base on balls, one hit batter, but four total free passes. Strike called. Good bounce back there to Ella Noak. Noak, a ground out and a strikeout today. Watch out, Macomb dugout, as Noak sends one over there. 0-2 quickly. It's a big out right here with one gone. It's a completely different ball game if you get that first out, or if it's two on with nobody aboard. Luckily, the fly out to Reyes put one away. Here's another tap foul, 0-2, it stays. Noak still looking for her very first RBI on the year. 15 total hits, 9 strikeouts. There's a fastball outside, 1-2. Kylie Douglas waiting on deck. She's got a pair of flyouts today to the left and center. One, two pitch, fouled away again. Noak doing a nice job of battling here with two strikes. Hard ground ball to second base, could be the play. Not with Prasnak playing so far off. She's in the hole between short and third, looking for that oppo swing. Thomas is even at second. Also, Zoe Hunt very far in left field. There's a fastball outside in the right-handed box. Noak is fighting here, makes it 2-2 with one out. Monarchs lead 2-0. We're in the top of the fifth inning. We're playing seven here in game one. Off speed, line drive, just over the glove of Byard at third. It's a foul ball, though. Good try from Bryn down there at the hot corner. It just sailed over her glove. What a fight from Ella Noak at the dish right now. Making that pitch count climb for Jakowski. This is number 64 here. Another foul ball. Home plate umpire Robert Hinojosa going to run out of softballs in a minute. Nope. A little bit of a reload there. He'll get a few back. The ninth pitch is lined back to the screen again. Big smile on the face of Ella Noak at the plate. She's fighting here against one of the best pitchers in the MCCAA East in Grace Jakowski. Grace had a six-inning no-hitter last week against Schoolcraft. It's the 15th in school history, first since 2017. Looking for a strikeout here on the 2-2. Just low. What a pitch. Very borderline there. Noak takes all the way, and that's what you love to see out of your leadoff hitter. Great plate discipline with two strikes. Full count with one out. There's two runners on. Jakowski delivers. Once again, fouled away. Noak went down swinging back in the third inning on some off speed. Jakowski might go with it here. She's been very consistent with that pitch, setting it in for a strike. Here's the 3-2. Swing and a miss. Fastball high at the eyes. The 12th pitch of the at-bat ends it. Strikeout number 5 for Jakowski. Kylie Douglas now with 2 out and 2 on. She's 0 for 2 today. Clutch strikeout for Grace Jakowski on the mound as she delivers a first pitch breaking ball high. Macomb got one in the second, one in the third, where we stand now at 2-0. Monarchs looking to take game one here, the doubleheader. Ball low, bouncing up to Stang. Both runners reached via the base on balls. Down at second, it's Ayolani Fernandez running for Caitlin Krizemin. Or Caitlin Postuma, excuse me. It's Cam Krizemin. 2-0, lined into left field, a base hit. Hunt can't field it in left field. It's underneath her glove. This could be two. Fernandez scores, coming around Goodman. They're not going to have a throw. A base hit, and then an error by Hunt in left has tied the ball game. Two-run double for Kylie Douglas. It's going to be chalked up as a single for Douglas. She reaches second on the error from Hunt in left field. She just didn't keep her glove on the ground. As an outfielder, you have to use your body or your glove to keep that in front. The last line of defense before the fence has to stay in front of you right there to save a run. It's tied, 2-2. That'll bring up Bella Lekitsky. Lekitsky made all three plays at shortstop to record all the outs in the fourth inning. One for 2 day for Bella right now. Holds the bat still over that right shoulder. And she'll pop one up in the air on the 1-0. Bill Poe at first base. Makes the catch straddling the line, and that ends the inning. Two runs score after the Douglas single and the botched ball in left from Zoe Hunt. We go to the bottom of the fifth inning, tied at 2 apiece between the Monarchs and the Hawks of Henry Ford. Be back in a minute. This is your home for Macomb Community College Athletics.
Sun is down, freezing cold, that's how we already know. When it's here, my dog will probably do it for Louis Bell. That's just all he know, he don't know nothing else. I tried to show him. Yeah. I tried to show him.
yeah, 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 yeah. Gone on you with the pick and roll. Young the flame, he in sicko mode.
At the gate outside, when they pull up, they give me loose. Yeah, jump out, boys. That's Nike boys hopping our coast. Way too big.
We're tied at two apiece.
Leading off
to get you to this point, Macomb scored one in the second. They then scratched up one more in the third. And just recently, the Henry Ford Hawks scored two runs in the top of the fifth inning. And at the dish right now, Allie Prasnak.
Yeah, yep. 344.
Prasnak by her Bill Poe here in the fifth. Caitlin Postuma increasing with that pitch count. That was number 85. She leaves it in the dirt low. Prasnak 0 for 1 with a walk today. Flew out to center, drew a walk back in the first. She was stranded at third base. She'll take a strike on the inside corner. It's 1-1. We talked about before the game, the theme for Macomb is to come out here and to dominate an opponent that is in the bottom of the standings here and take both games. Got to focus on number one here and get it done. There's a strike on the outside corner. The reason Macomb is lingering in that number two spot in the MCCAA East is they've split their last three doubleheaders. Have to be able to take both and sweep. Prasnak swings and misses. She's gone. Fastball in the outside corner from Postuma makes it one gone.
The batter, number 24, Bryn Boyer.
Byers 1-for-2 today. Singled and scored in the third. Same spot as that last pitch to Prasnak. Caught on and missed from Byer 0-1. Two runs on three hits with one error for Macomb. Two runs on two hits with one error for Henry Ford. Byer pops this one out of play. The same spot, that pitch kind of swinging out to the corner away from the right-handed hitter. O-2, off the end of the bat, onto shortstop. Lekitsky guns to first. Two up, two down in the bottom of the fifth. We're gonna get time right now as...
Number 14, Carly.
No, we weren't. Thought we were for a second. Thought I heard head coach Steve Littleton of Henry Ford call time. Carly Bilpo's turn. Two outs, nobody on in a tie ball game. Postuma delivers a first pitch fastball in the inside corner. 0-1. Bill Poe drove in the run in the third inning. Hit a ground ball to second base that was booted. Allowed Bryn Boyer to come around and score. 0-1. Is now even at 1-1. Pitch in the dirt. Same spot, down and away. Bill Poe takes that on the lower outside corner. Monarchs averaging just over 7 runs per game, underachieving that here in game one. It's been great pitching on the mound from Caitlin Postuma. She's really hit her spots. That off-speed pitch is a little bit high, 3-2 now. Got a battle here with two strikes. Want to be smart with a full count. Bill Poe chokes up. She's going to float one out to second base. Oliver goes back. It's over her head. Bloop single for Carly Bill Poe with two outs. And that's how things get started here. Leadoff hitter. Or if you're able to put one on with two outs. Can always start a rally. Katie Thomas now 0-for-1 with a walk. Glad to have all of you along today for both. Reminder that game two will be on a separate video link, so make sure you click out of here. Go back to the regular Macomb Monarchs page and click on to game two later on today after the conclusion of this one. Thomas took the first pitch for a strike. Postuma ready. Pulled on the ground. This ball's just foul. A few balls down there on the third base side. Just foul. No balls and two strikes right now to Katie Thomas, the defending MCCAA East Player of the Week. Six doubles, 11 for 14 last week. She was red hot. She fouls this pitch away. Staying alive on 0-2. Postuma gets her sign. The 0-2 off-speed pitch on the corner for strike three. Couple of strikeouts in the frame for Caitlin Postuma. Those were her first two of the entire ball game. We go to the top of the sixth inning. 2-2 tie. The Hawks hold the Monarchs at bay. This is your home for Macomb Community College Athletics. You're listening to the Macomb Athletic Network.
Leading off the Hawks, 34, Jada Oliver.
Hawks come to bat here in the sixth inning, led by Jada Oliver. Millie Garcia and Cam Krizemin to follow. The first pitch from Jakowski is not close. Shaking her head right now as she looks over towards the third base dugout at head coach Jim Beard. Jakowski has thrown 80 total pitches. She's allowed two runs on two hits with five strikeouts and three walks. Oliver takes the 1-0 back to the screen, evens it up 1-1. Oliver, a sophomore out of Detroit, Michigan, went to Cass Tech High School. She's 0 for 2 right now. Ground out and a flyout. She'll pull one in the air, back towards the press box, out of play. Oliver allowed that second run to score from Macomb. That's the difference right now. Both teams with one error that has led to that second run. Jakowski delivers a 1-2 pitch. Fly ball to shallow center field. It's going to stay on the infield. Thomas goes back a few steps and makes the catch.
The batter 40, Myla Garcia.
Oliver just got off the end of the bat right there. Not much you could do with it as Jakowski put it right on the outside corner again. Looking at some late game drama right now as we're tied at two in the sixth inning. Jakowski delivers. This one's lined right back at us. 0 for 1 day with a walk for Millie Garcia. She struck out looking last time and walked back in the second. Strike called outside corner. Quickly 0-2 to Garcia. And in the same at-bat, Jakowski can look totally dialed in, and other times a little bit sporadic with her pitches. Just a little bit of both right now, but she's only given up two runs on two hits, being very effective. That's off the plate outside. Another shake of the head makes it 1-2. Kowski leans in, rocks back. 1-2 in the dirt. Stang lets it pass by her. Two more hits right now as well for Henry Ford. Or check that for McComb. Beyer, who's got one, obviously Urban swing. Mitchell, here's another foul ball, keeps it at 2-2. And then Bilpo last standing as well. Swing and a miss on the 2-2. Sixth strikeout for Grace Jakowski. And that's a big one to put two gone with Cam Krizemin at the dish. Second strikeout of the day for Garcia. Very effective on the mound, especially with the off-speed pitches and those fastballs outside to right-handed hitters. It's been the bread and butter all day long for Grace. And she goes opposite corner now in her half to Krizemin, makes it 0-1. Cameron's 0-for-1 with a hit by pitch today, struck out swinging in the fourth inning. Little chop swing at that inside fastball, 0-2. McComb would love to get out of this frame quickly and then have a big swing. Sydney Urban leads off the bottom of the sixth inning. Swing and a miss at a fastball outside. Stang gonna have to throw on to first on the drop third strike. Seven strikeouts for Grace Jakowski through six innings. Following up an incredible no-hit performance her last time out against Schoolcraft. We go to the bottom of the sixth, tie game, two apiece. McComb trying to take the lead and win it in the top half of the seventh inning. This is your home for McComb Community College Athletics.
Your attention, please. Now pitching for the Hawks, 11, Jessica Hazel. Leading off for the Monarchs, 00, Sydney Urban.
It's a 2-2 tie ball game as we go to the bottom of the sixth inning. Along for the ride in both games, Tom Cavanaugh, as we get set for Sydney Urban's at-bat, we have a bunch of defensive substitutions. Over at third base, Caitlin Postuma, her day is done on the mound. She's at third. Jalen Reyes moves from third base to second. Jada Oliver moves from second to first base. So the infield has completely switched besides Bella Lakitsky at second, and the first pitch is a strike called to Urban. Strike swung at him, sorry. 0-1, Sydney cut and a miss at a fastball high. She's down 0-2. It's Jessica Hosel, the lefty on the mound now. Sophomore making her 12th appearance of the year. She's 1-7 record on the year with 60 hits allowed and 51 in a third innings. Urban flies it back to the screen, keeping it at 0-2. It's a 1-for-2 day for Sydney. She's responsible for half of the runs today for McComb. She's got a solo shot. Also lined out to third base her last time. It was a screamer. 0-2 from Hosel. Swing and a miss. Urban goes down.
The batter.
Krasnak, Thomas, and Urban all struck out in the last couple of innings. Three of their better hitters. And Hosel, she gets an early strikeout start, and Mitchell off balance there. Takes a strike on the outside corner. Check swing, she definitely went around, 0-2. Jessica Hosel is money on the mound right now. 40 strikeouts and just 10 walks in those 51 and a third innings. So she fills up the strike zone and gets a lot of swing and misses. And there's another one. Off-speed pitch has Mitchell out in front, and it's back-to-back strikeouts on just 6 pitches. Wow. Zoe Hunt, she's 0-for-1 with a walk today. No plan right now at the dish for the Monarch hitters. Jessica Hosel is just leaving them in a pretzel. Coming from that left side, it's a different delivery. Hunt makes it 7 straight strikes as she lines one back. Two tie in the sixth. Bunt attempt. Doesn't hit the bat, it's 0-2. She offered. Hunt down to her final strike here in the sixth inning. Grace Jakowski likely back on the mound in the seventh. It's the 7, 8, 9 hitters due up for Henry Ford in the seventh inning. Hunt, swing and a miss. What an inning from Jessica Hosel. She just struck out all 3 hitters on just 9 pitches. 3 swinging strikeouts to McComb. And we go to the seventh inning. Henry Ford battling. We're tied at 2. This is your home for McComb Community College Athletics.
Leading off for the Hawks, 15, Jalen Reyes.
7, 8, 9 hitters to face Grace Jakowski. Grace today, she has been incredible. 2 hits, 2 runs allowed, none of them earned, 3 walks, and 7 strikeouts. She faces Jalen Reyes. Tipped into the glove for strike 1. Pop out to the catcher on a bunt attempt and a fly out to shallow left field for Jalen today. She just moved from third base over to second. Swing and a miss. Not close as that one misses the bat by a good couple of inches. Swinging fastball just kind of curves out on that outside half. The 0-2. Same spot for strike 3. 3 straight strikeouts, and that's the 8th total for Grace Jakowski. Both pitchers locked in right now. We just saw Jessica Hosel strike out the side on 9 pitches. And then on three right there, Reyes goes down looking. Here's Postuma. Ended her day on the mound after last inning. She's playing third base now. 0 for 1 with a walk and a run scored. Ayolani Fernandez actually pinch ran for her and make it four straight strikes for Jakowski. Right in the outside corner. Tap back to the mound on the 0-1. Nice play from Grace. Toss over to first, and there's two away. Fielding her position as well as throwing it. Grace does a nice job hopping out of that pitcher's circle there. Another 0 for 1 day with a walk and a run scored for Ashley Goodman. Looking at this box score here, McComb has allowed both of the 8 and 9 batters to walk and come around and score. That's outside. Usually when you look at those box scores, you want to see those runners, that run production coming from the 3 through 6 spot right there. That's where the meat and potatoes, the best hitters in the lineup kind of sit. It's never good when the lower 8 or 9 hitters get it done. 1-1, big swing and a miss on a half-hearted hack from Ashley Goodman. Jakowski seeking her 9th strikeout. We're in the top of the 7th inning, 2-2 tie. Swing and a miss, 1-2. Missing bats like crazy right now for Grace Jakowski. Gets her sign, rocks back. Arm over the head, and that's outside, 2-2. Gotta finish the inning at the very bottom of the lineup here with Goodman at the plate. She said 0 for 1, she struck out looking. The 2-2, back to the screen. That was pitch number 100 for Jakowski today. We're in game one of a doubleheader from Warren, Michigan on the campus of Macomb Community College. All tied up, twos are wild on the board. Foul again from Goodman. Continuing to fight. A very uncharacteristic day at the plate for Macomb, just 2 total runs. One of them was earned. And 4 total hits. Strike 3 on the corner. How about Grace Jakowski through 7 strong innings? She allows 2 hits, 2 runs, and 9 strikeouts. McComb's going to try to win it here in the bottom half of the 7th inning. Casey Stang, Savannah Clark, and Allie Prasnak do up. Be back in a minute. You're watching the Macomb Athletic Network.
Your attention, please. Pinch hitting for the Monarchs, number 1, Lexi Murray.
To start off the bottom of the 7th against Jessica Hazel, who just struck out the side in the 6th, is Lexi Murray the pinch hitter. First pitch is outside for a ball. Murray hitting in place of Casey Stang, and then it is Savannah Clark and Ellie Prasnak. Murray, 5 total hits and 25 at-bats, hitting a cool 200 with 3 doubles. Swings and misses at that one. Inside corner. Levels the count at 1 apiece. Hazel has just been crafty. We haven't seen her for long today, but likely in game 2. Just threw 9 pitches last inning and struck out all 3. Murray lines it to the screen. One ball, 2 strikes to the pinch hitter. Murray is aboard. Likely going to stay at first. She hasn't stolen a bag all year. Two balls and two strikes. Nice take there as it's down and away. Ozel threw her windup. The 2-2 bounces up. Tried to go with the off speed again. This time leaves it a little bit short. Kaitlyn Postuma is now at third base. Lakitsky stays at shortstop. Reyes moved to second, and Oliver's playing first. Outfield is all the same. 3-2 pitches high and inside for a ball. How about Lexi Murray drawing the walk? She was down 1-2 in the count, and she works it all the way back. First base runner, or first batter that didn't result in a strikeout for Jess Hazel on the mound. Savannah Clark now, 0-for-3 day. She's going to put a bunt down. This is a good one. She's safe at first. Kylie Douglas had to hop out of her stance, had no play anywhere. Textbook bunt from Clark, and it's 2-on with nobody out. She dropped it right in front of the catcher, Douglas. That's a tough play to make, too, for Kylie behind the plate. Had to jump out of the stance, move her body all the way around so that she had a chance to throw, and Clark was too fast. Prasnak puts one down the first baseline. It is fair ball past a diving Noak. Coming around third to score. This game is over. Walk-off victory. The Macomb Monarchs win it on Allie Prasnak's base hit down the right field line. Nobody's getting off the field for some reason. This game is over. Come on. Monarchs get it done 3-2. Prasnak gets her first hit of the ball game and drops it down the right field line. Lexi Murray led that inning off with a walk, and two pitches later, Prasnak wins it. Not the best day offensively for the Monarchs, but one way or the other, they get this thing done. Grace Jakowski was phenomenal. She is your player of the game. 9 strikeouts, 2 hits, 2 runs allowed. Incredible game from Grace once again. She has done it all year long for these Monarchs. We're going to be back in about 25 minutes for game 2. How about Allie Prasnak winning it for Macomb in a walk-off fashion 3-2 victory in game 1. 25 minutes, game 2. We will be back with both of these teams, Macomb and Henry Ford. It's a big game for both. Thanks so much, everybody, for tuning in for game 1. Your final score one more time. Macomb gets it done in walk-off fashion, 3-2, thanks to Allie Prasnak dropping one down the right field line. Thanks so much. We'll see you soon. I'm on your body.